The Speech Resource Company presents Historic Moments in Speech.
I'm Robert Wikstrom with another chapter of Historic Moments in Speech. This time, we focus on speeches delivered by candidates running for office, beginning with the first presidential election entered by Franklin Delano Roosevelt in 1932. It was the first election held during the Great Depression. FDR was the well-known and popular governor of New York, running against the Republican incumbent Herbert Hoover, who had won the previous election in a landslide. Roosevelt repeatedly blamed Hoover for the Depression and worsening economy. He promised recovery with his New Deal program. In this speech, Governor Roosevelt accepts the Democrat Party nomination at the convention held in Chicago on this day, Saturday, July 2nd, 1932.
Chairman Walsh, my friends of the Democratic National Convention of 1932, I appreciate your willingness after these six arduous days to remain here, for I know well the sleepless hours which you and I have had. I regret that I am late, but I had no control over the winds of heaven and could only be thankful for my Navy training. The appearance before a national convention of its nominee for president to be formally notified of his selection is unprecedented and unusual. But these are unprecedented and unusual times. I have started out on the tasks that lie ahead by breaking the absurd tradition that the candidate should remain in professed ignorance of what has happened for weeks until he is formally notified of that event many weeks later. My friends, may this be the symbol of my intention to be honest and to avoid all hypocrisy or sham. You have nominated me, and I know it, and I am here to thank you for the honor. Let it also be symbolic that in so doing, I broke traditions. Let it be from now on the task of our party to break foolish traditions. We will break foolish traditions and leave it to the Republican leadership, far more skilled in that art, to break promises. Let us now and here highly resolve to resume the country's uninterrupted march along the path of real progress, of real justice, of real equality for all of our citizens, great and small. Our indomitable leader in that interrupted march is no longer with us, but there still survives today his spirit. Many of his captains, thank God, are still with us to give us wise counsel. Let us feel that in everything we do, there still lives with us, if not the body, the great, indomitable, unquenchable, progressive soul of our Commander-in-Chief, Woodrow Wilson.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.